Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on example problem on lattice and distributive lattice. In this problem, we have to verify that whether the given problem is lattice or a distributive lattice or not. Okay. Here in this given problem, okay, set A is equal to set of elements 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 5 comma 30, okay, and the given relation R is the divisibility relation. Now prove that A comma R is a lattice or not. A comma R is a lattice or not. First we have to prove. Okay. Here A is a finite set that contains the elements 1, 2, 3, 5 and 30. R is the divisibility relation. The divisibility relation can be defined on the elements of set A. Okay, now we have to prove that A comma R is a lattice or not. Okay, we can take any pair of elements of A. That pair of elements contains both least upper bound and greatest lower bound. Hence, we can say that A comma R is a lattice. First, we have to find out the least upper bound for every pair of elements of set A. Okay. So, we have to write the LUB table. That is the least upper bound table. Okay. For LUB table, first we have to write all the elements of set A in row wise and column wise. 1, 2, 3, 5, 30. Okay. In the same way, column wise, 1, 2, 3, 5 and 30. Okay. So, before filling out the LUB table, first we have to draw the Hussey diagram for A comma R. So, here I am writing Hussey diagram. Okay, so the Hussey diagram is, first I am taking element 1. Next element is 2. Okay, 1 divides 2. Because there is a divisibility relationship between the pair of elements 1 and 2. So 1 divides 2, so that we have to draw the edge between 1 and 2. Next element is 3. I am writing element 3 here. 2 does not divide 3. So that we do not draw the edge between 2 and 3. 1 divides 3. Yes. So that we have to draw the edge between 1 and 3. Okay. Next element is 5. Okay. So the element 5 is 2 divides 5? No. 3 divides 5? No. 1 divides 5? Yes. Here, I am writing element 5. 1 divides 5. Okay. But not 2 divides 5 and 3 divides 5. So that we do not draw the edge between 2 and 5 and 3 and 5. But only 1 divides 5. So that we have to draw the edge between 1 and 5. Next element is 30. 5 divides 30. Yes. 2 divides 30. Yes. 3 divides 30. Yes. So, here I am taking element 30. Okay. So, 2 divides 30. So, that we have to draw the edge between them. Next, 5 divides 30. So, that we have to draw the edge between them. 3 divides 30. So, that we have to draw the edge between them. So, this is the Hussey diagram of set A with relation called as divisibility relation. This is the Fuzzy diagram. Now we have to fill out the LUB table by observing the given Fuzzy diagram. Okay, first one here LUB can be represented by this symbol. Okay, one, this symbol is also called as join. Okay, one join one, that means least upper bound of 1 comma 1 is nothing but 1. Okay, next 1 join 2. 1 join 2, what is the least upper bound of 1 and 2? That is 2. Next 1 join 3, that means least upper bound of 1 and 3 is 3. Next 1 join 5, the least upper bound of 1 and 5 is 5. Next 1 join 30, the least upper bound of 1 and 30 is 30. Okay, next one, 2 join 1. What is the least upper bound of 2 and 1 is 2. 2 join 2, least upper bound of 2 is 2. Next, 2 join 3, the least upper bound of 2 and 3 is 30. Next, the least upper bound of 2 and 5 is 30. Next, the least upper bound of 2 and 30 is 30. Next one, 3 join 1, 3 join 1, the least upper bound of 3 and 1 is 3. 3 join 2, 3 join 2, what is the least upper bound of 3 and 2? That is 30. 3 join 3, the least upper bound of 3 comma 3 is 3. Next, 3 join 5, the least upper bound of 3 and 5 is 30. Next, 3 join 30, the least upper bound of 3 comma 30 is 30. Next one, 5 join 1, the least upper bound of 5 and 1 is 5. 5 join 2, the least upper bound of 5 and 2 is 30. 5 join 3, the least upper bound of 5 and 3 is 30. 5 join 5, the least upper bound of 5 and 5 is 5. 5 join 30, the least upper bound of 5 and 30 is 30. Okay, next one. 30 join 1, the least upper bound of 30 and 1 is 30. 30 join 2, the least upper bound of 30 and 2 is 30. 30 join 3, the least upper bound of 30 and 3 is 30. 30 join 5, the least upper bound of 30 and 5 is 30. 30 join 30, the least upper bound of 30 comma 30 is 30. So this is called as the LUB table. By observing this table, for every pair of elements, the least upper bound exists. Okay, so I am writing here, by observing the LUB table, comma, for every pair of elements in set A, comma, LUB exists. Okay, now we can go for GLB table. Okay, here I am writing GLB table. So we have to check for every pair of elements. So test lower bound exists or not. First, we are writing all the elements of A in row wise and column wise. 1, 2, 3, 5, 30. 1, 2, 3, 5, 30. So the greatest lower bound can be denoted by using this symbol. Okay. So 1, meet 1. This symbol is also called as meet or a greatest lower bound. So 1 meet 1 is nothing but 1. So the meet operation between 1 and 2 is nothing but the greatest lower bound of 1 and 2 is 1. Next, The meet operation of 1 and 3 is nothing but greatest lower bound of 1 and 3 is 1. Next, the meet operation between 1 and 5 is nothing but the greatest lower bound of 1 and 5 is 1. Next one, 1 meet 30 is nothing but the greatest lower bound of 1 and 30 is nothing but 1. Okay, next, 2 meet 1. 2 meet 1, the greatest lower bound of 2 and 1 is 1. 2 meet 2, the greatest lower bound of 2 comma 2 is 2. Next, 2 meet 3, the greatest lower bound of 2 and 3 is 1. Next, 2 meet 5, the greatest lower bound of 2 and 5 is 1. Next one, the meet operation between 2 and 30 is nothing but the greatest lower bound of 2 and 30 is 2. Next one, 3 meet 1, the greatest lower bound of 3 and 1 is 1. 3 meet 2, the greatest lower bound of 3 and 2 is 1. Next, 3 meet 3, the greatest lower bound of 3 is 3. 3 meet 5, the greatest lower bound of 3 and 5 is 1. 3 meet 30, the greatest lower bound of 3 and 30 is 3. Next one, 5 meet 1, the greatest lower bound 5 and 1 is 1. 5 meet 2, the greatest lower bound of 5 and 2 is 1. 5 meet 3, greatest lower bound of 5 and 3 is 1. 5 meet 5, only 5. 5 and 30, the operation between 5 and 30 is greatest lower bound of 5 and 30 is 5. Next one, 30 meet 1. The greatest lower bound of 30 and 1 is 1. 30 meet 2. The greatest lower bound of 30 and 2 is 2. 30 meet 3. That is the greatest lower bound of 30 and 3 is 3. 30 meet 5. The greatest lower bound of 30 and 5 is 5. 30 meet 30. That is the greatest lower bound of 30 and 30 is 13. So that means, by observing the GLB table for every pair of elements, so GLB is exist. By observing the GLB table for every pair of elements, for every pair of elements in set A, GLB exist. GLB exist. Okay. So therefore, for every pair of elements, for every pair of elements in set A, comma, both LOB and GLB exist. So hence, we can say that A comma R is a lattice. A comma R is a lattice. So we can prove that the given condition on the given set is a lattice or not by finding the LUB table and the GLB table. Both LUB table and GLB table can be filled out using Fuzzy diagram. So observing the Fuzzy diagram, LUB table and GLB table, hence we can say that A comma R is a lattice, because every pair of elements set A, both upper bound and greater lower bound exist. We can say that A comma R is lattice. Next, we have to prove that whether this lattice is a distributed lattice or not. Okay. A lattice is A lattice is a distributive lattice. If and only if it satisfies the condition, conditions. So first one is A join B meet C is equal to A join B meet A join C. So this is the first condition. Whether it satisfies or not. Whether it is a satisfied, then we have to check for second condition. Okay. Otherwise, we can say that the lattice is not a distributive lattice. And the second term is A meet B join C is equal to A meet B join A meet C. First, we need to verify the first condition. Verify 1. Okay. So, here I am taking A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, and C is equal to 3. Okay. Here, all B, B, C belongs to LA. So A value 2, B value 3 and C value 3 I am taken. 2, 3, 3 belongs to the LA. Substitute these values in equation 1. This one. So 2 join 3 meet. This is 5. This is 5. 2 join 3 meet 5. Is equal to 2 join 3 and 2 join 5. Okay. 2 join 3 and 2 join 5. Okay. So here 2 join 3 meet 5. Pair of elements 3 and 5, greatest lower bound is 1. Is equal to 2 meet 3. 2 join 3. The least upper of 2 and 3 is 30. And 2 join 5, the rest of the amount of 2 and 5 is 30. 30 meet 30. 30 meet 30 is nothing. Yet, 30 meet 30 is nothing but 30. 2 join 1. So, 2 join 1, the rest of the amount of 2 and 1 is. So, 2 now equal to 30. Okay. So, not satisfied. So, the first condition is satisfied. Then, we will check the second condition. If the first condition is not satisfied, then there is no need of checking the second condition. Hence, we can say that, therefore, we can say that A, R is not a distributive lattice. Thus, the first condition is not satisfied. Then, without checking the second condition, we see that A, comma, R is not a distributive lattice because HS is not equal to HS of the condition. Hence, okay. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. And